what's really unique about this band is that it's kind of weird. Like, you're not really sure of the destination, but you all know when you get there, and that's the driving force behind it, is like trying to find that equilibrium of sound where all of our ideas and our sounds like combine together, and everything else external to that, it's like it matters, but like the only way to really unify is if you just kind of, that's your driving focus.
All the songs called for a different thing. This space is like, we've definitely done some really cool stuff in this space. But we also did some of the best stuff on the record, like at Perrin's place, just in his bedroom. And it's just like, there's no soundproofing, and there's like, you know.
There's a cat that's
just like meowing. I mean, I love Benny, but he's
beautiful cat.
This cat that just sounds like a really sad child all the time, just.
We put him through a vocoder.
He's on the album, yeah.
We had to put him on the album, yeah.
And it was also really cool to like just get out of the city and like know that you have a couple of days to just like purely track.
The thing I really enjoyed about, yeah, having that time, like they were saying, within having that amount of time, you sort of get to the point where you can start to experiment with how you want to do things. It was 2 a.m, and the sound engineer was in the, all of a sudden we were manning the controls, and he was recording a wine glass at the end of this track and sounded incredible. It was like, yeah, that's great. You know, those kind of things happen when you've got that much time and you can really start to explore what you want to actually capture. You know, you're not sort of restricted by, we've got an hour to go, let's quickly track this thing. I think that's how you capture the really incredible shit on records.
It was so fun to play in that room when, like, as an experimenting time, like on Molasses.
That's right. We had a plane going over top.
Oh, no, yeah, no,
helicopter. There was a lot of that on this album, just like having headphones and listening to like how crazy the world sounds.
For us, it's relatively simple. The direction. The direction is wherever we want to go. Like there's no holds bar, you know? We can take it wherever we want, really. And if everyone's into it, then it kind of goes there.
For me, if there's any one direction I'd want to take with it, would be just keep going outwards from where we've started in as many directions as possible.
I've found that if you let things go, or like at least leave it open to, you know, what are you talking about? Leave it open to like interpretation, it can be so much bigger than you ever originally imagined as well.
Everyone's always happy with the decision at the end, but I don't think like all four of us have, it's rare, but sometimes we do have the exact same vision on like one specific thing. Mm-hmm. It's always a bit like, you know, scattered around, which is cool and it's healthy, is you don't want it to be like dominated by one person either.
I feel like that's how our music is so genre eclectic, is because even in the invisible threads, there's so many multiple layers of influence in every detail and in everybody's contribution. And I feel like that's how it comes together. It's like somehow, it's like a molecular thing of seeing the similarities between things that are can seem so polar opposite.